Hi, let's talk about the trachea. The trachea is a conductive pathway distal to the larynx and proximal to the primary or main stem bronchi. It's a part of the bronchial tree, which we'll discuss in the context of the lungs and the conductive pathway. We can see the trachea beginning here and running behind some of the branches of the arch of the aorta. So we can see the brachiocephalic trunk, as well as the left common carotid artery. We can see the left recurrent laryngeal nerve ascending here. And the trachea is suspended from the larynx, specifically the cricoid cartilage, by this cricotracheal ligament. We can also see some of the cartilaginous rings which form the wall of the trachea that give patency to the airway, that help to maintain it in its open state. We can also see more of that cricotracheal ligament in the posterior here as well. So this is a transverse section of the trachea. We're looking at it from the posterior, and we can see there are those cartilaginous rings which are helping to maintain the patency. And then the posterior wall of the trachea is without cartilage. In fact, it's formed of connective tissue and smooth muscle. When we incise those rings and open it up, we can see some of the elements of that smooth muscle here that we call the trachealis. So the trachealis is under autonomic control. There isn't a great deal of control of the airway here. You know, that's done at the level of the bronchiole, where there is much more smooth muscle relative to cartilage. But there is some smooth muscle here to control the patency of the airway. And it is autonomically innervated. Parasympathetically, there is more tone to the smooth muscle. Sympathetically, there is less tone. So during a sympathetic response, the smooth muscle of the wall of the airway relaxes to allow it to be more patent to aid in ventilation. Thank you very much for your time.